So once again, I'd like to welcome you all for the session of Power Automate and SharePoint Online, where we'll be trying to find different automations and that can be integrated directly with a SharePoint. So before starting the session, I would like to introduce myself. And this is me. My full name is Rahul Nandi. I have certifications over different technologies. Especially, I focus and deliver courses on Microsoft. And have the experience on Power Platform, Microsoft Teams, Microsoft Administrations. And before this, I have worked in different companies and I have closely worked in Microsoft Technologies in L1, L2, and L3 teams. At the moment, I only deliver courses for Microsoft. I deliver courses for Modern Works and ServiceNow. And today we'll be going to discuss about everything about the SharePoint Online and the automation that we can configure through Power Automate. So first, we would like to know a little bit about the cloud concept, because the SharePoint integration that we are looking forward, that's directly have a relation with SharePoint Online. So SharePoint Online is a cloud-based platform. So for the cloud-based platform, we have many softwares out there at the moment in the market. SharePoint is one of them. But in SharePoint, we have different things to do, different things to perform. So on the cloud platform related things, in today's world, we have seen there are many companies offering cloud solutions like Google. We have Amazon Web Services, and obviously we have Microsoft and their cloud platforms and solutions. Now, why we need cloud? First of all, previously, when the cloud concept was not there, we used to work from offices. The challenge was in the office scenarios, we won't be able to work outside from our office. We have to be present inside the office. Then only we can access all the applications and the resources. Later on, we need to spend a lot of amount in terms of the expenditure, in the sense of buying the manufacturing devices, buying the computers to have all the functionalities in a separate room in form of data center. We need a certain amount of money to do that. But the cloud solution offers the same thing in a remote location or a separate location from the cloud service providers, which we can use in very lower cost. So it's a cost-effective thing. We can use this from different locations, and all this would be helpful for us. Now, what Microsoft Cloud offers, they have different things in today's world. And rapidly, we are accelerating towards the AI technology. But if you just focus about, apart from AI, there are various things offered by Microsoft. We have infrastructure in terms of virtual machines and all this. We have digital applications innovation. We have data and AI. We have modern work. We have business applications. And we have security. Now, why I have focused into the modern work? Because all the things which we are going to cover in today's one-hour session, that would be related to the modern work. That would be related to the SharePoint, Power Automate. Because in modern work, we deal with the applications which is related to SharePoint, PowerPoint, Excel, Word, Outlook. So these are the daily life used applications. Now, if someone is working alone, that means that person do not need to share any information with others. I mean, if I'm using my own device, my phone, my laptop, if I would like to store any file or any application, I do not need any platform to do that with others. I would like to separate that thing from others. So for that, we have Google Drive, we have OneDrive, we have Apple Cloud, something like this. Similarly, when we are working alone, we have a solution from Microsoft, which is known as OneDrive. So have you guys used the OneDrive? Can you just mention in the chat box? I'd like to know if you have used this OneDrive before or hearing this for the first time. Okay. So maximum of the participants in the session, I can see they have used the OneDrive. So that's great. So we are already familiar with how the OneDrive works. Similarly, for the teamwork, when we are working with a team in a group or in a department, we need a solution where we can interact or share file with our teammates, with our colleagues. So for that, we have multiple applications. One of the famous and renowned application that we are using at the moment, that is Microsoft Teams. Apart from Teams, we have another application which is known as SharePoint. Like Teams, we cannot do video calls or direct calls on SharePoint because SharePoint is like a website for our organization, which can be only accessed by our colleagues, our teammates. So it has multiple advantages. We can use for document sharing, we can use to publish content, we can use that for different engagement or something like that. Now in SharePoint, we have different categories. As I said, SharePoint is like a website. So we can create different kinds of website. Mainly it's categorized into two parts. One, it's a communication site. Another is it's a team site. Team site is like exactly that we can do in Microsoft Teams. That's for sharing content for both the ways, or while you share some content, your colleague can share this content at the same time. But for the communication part, for the communication website in SharePoint, all the people who are added into a single SharePoint site, they cannot communicate or share file with each other. It works like only one person have the access to share the file with all of them, and others have the option to download or view the content. So it works like a large audience would see the content and one person would forward that one information to others. So that is the part of communication side. So here in this, in the starting of our session, we have understood to share content, we have two platforms. One is Microsoft Teams and one is SharePoint. And to work alone, we have one application from Microsoft that is known as OneDrive. Now, we are discussing about SharePoint. Why we are focusing about SharePoint so much? Because SharePoint is something which is very helpful for us to manage the different content that I have. And that can be helpful to integrate with all the applications out there from Microsoft. Now, how this is possible? Because of the cloud technology. SharePoint Online is not limited to any particular geographical location. This SharePoint Online can be accessed from all the browsers out there. To access that, we have a small solutions out there. I'll just share my screen once again. Let me share the screen. Can you guys see my screen? Is it visible? That's great. Thanks for the confirmation. Okay. So I know many of you guys know how to access SharePoint, but just for the information, I'll show it on my screen. First, to access the SharePoint or any application from Microsoft, we need to visit office.com. This is the landing page for all the applications out there. So the URL is www.office.com. I'll post this URL in the chat box. This is the landing page for all the Microsoft applications out there. Now inside office.com, once you log in for the first time, you'll be able to find all the applications under this 9 dots on top left corner. If you click on this, you'll be able to find all the applications that you have access at the moment. From this list of applications, you need to choose SharePoint. So after opening SharePoint, you'll be able to see all the websites which you have created. If you haven't created any, you can create one by clicking on this create site and choosing the options that I said, team site and communication site. So both have their own advantages you need to go with as per your requirement. So to save the time, I have created a team site already, which is known as Football Club. I have given the name and I have designed the team site already, and how to design the SharePoint, how to create a SharePoint site for your organization. We have a separate course. I mean, being a training company, we provide different courses and solutions for different, if you have any customized requirement for your company to build any SharePoint course or something like that, we provide that.
So if you have interest and if you'd like to know how to create this kind of SharePoint site, we have that option. As I said, I have given my email ID at the starting. And also, we have our website, which is koenigsolutions.com, where you can browse and you can talk to our sales executives and give your requirement, and they would be able to help you to fulfill that. So this is the site which we have already created, which is exactly looking like the website out there, like any other website like Amazon, Flipkart, or any website. So inside that, we have one thing which is called list. List is just like the Excel file that we use inside online. So if we want to browse the list, we have an option for site content, and we can create the list from this new option. And to save the time again, I have already created a list, and this is how a list looks like, where we can define multiple columns and we can make different entries with all the kinds of information which I would like to insert inside the list. I can do that. If I would like to edit, I can go into the edit view and I can make changes over here. So why it is important for our course to create a list, to create the automation? I will explain that while going ahead explaining the PPT. As I was saying, SharePoint is the central repository for all the information, and you can integrate multiple applications with SharePoint. We have the option to integrate Teams, OneNote, Outlook, Power BI, PowerPoint, and Yammer, List, and all this. Next, there are different services offered by SharePoint. Now, SharePoint is not only a website, it helps to create and manage our daily content, and it helps to store that at the same time. Now, these are the features of SharePoint. I mean, these are the basic features. There are multiple other features as well, but if I would like to conclude all the essential features of SharePoint, I can go with teamwork, web pages, that comes under the design part. I have the centrally management portion where I can manage things for other people. I can store a file and I can publish it for our teammates, whether they can view it or not, or they can download it or not. I can manage that. Next, we have the search option where we can search multiple things inside SharePoint, inside the organization. If you have any content shared and can be found easily, can done by SharePoint. We have the social experience where in SharePoint, we can put the feedback. We can put the different information. We can share it with other teammates. And this is the most important part, which we are going to focus today about: Power Automate and Capture. So automation and capture is one of the essential and important thing, because whenever we are going to make an entry inside SharePoint list, by default, we need to get inside and open the SharePoint first. Without opening the SharePoint, it's not possible to insert the data. That is where the Power Automate comes into the picture. Because in automation, we want to reduce our task, which is repetitive. We would not like to perform the task again and again. That's where we'll learn how we can integrate that with the SharePoint. Next, not only Power Automate, we'll be also taking help for other office application, which is Microsoft Forms. With the help of Microsoft Forms, we can integrate that with SharePoint to take the data from different people. Inside SharePoint, as I said, there are two type of sites we have. They have different features. These are the different features that these two type of site offers, which we have already discussed. And this is how a list looks like. I have already showed you guys on my screen by opening the SharePoint. And what exactly the definition of a list, if you ask me, it's a web-based table of information, and the information can be added to a form. So that form which we are going to add the information is look like this. If I open the list and if I just click on new, a form will pop up. This is the form. If I put any information over here, so if I would like to put a new entry, if someone has joined in our organization, and I would like to put the entry. So the last entry, I have the name with Tom and their phone number, email address, and the department. So if I if I am the manager of an organization or of my team, and I would like to make a new entry over here. So for that, I need to click on new. I can put the name of the person as Peter. I can put the phone number as 123456. I need to put the email address as peter.rozon@abc.com. Just for an example. So I can choose the department. Peter has joined in sales team. And if I have any attachment, I can attach that, or I would like to save it. Once I save that, I can see a new entry has popped up over here on my SharePoint list. Now, what's the significance of this kind of feature? If I have made entry or a list of information over here, I can easily export that to an Excel file, to a Power BI file, with schema or CSV file very easily, because this page is dynamic. I can make changes over here. And if I want to not make any changes, I can set that as well. So that comes into the security part of SharePoint. That's again another dimension of SharePoint, because in SharePoint, we have multiple areas to focus. So mostly in SharePoint, we have three major sectors. The one sector is design. Okay? Another sector is management. Another sector is security. So all this together, it forms this SharePoint, which is our website. So today we are focusing on the management part with the help of list and Power Automate or the automation. So we have understood how the list works, but the problem is at this moment we have the list of content over here, but do we want that all the list of contents that the information needs to be gathered over here that would be technically given by by the person who has entered inside the list. So that means I need to give the access to someone always to get inside the list, and then they can make the new entries. Okay, I think someone has shared something on the chat box. Okay. The webinar has been started at 1 o'clock, 1 p.m. IST. And can you guys hear my voice? Am I audible? Others? Okay. So in that case, I would request those people who are not able to hear me. Could you please, I would request you guys to rejoin in the session once again, if that's possible, because I can get the confirmation from others. They can hear me. Yeah. So I'll continue from the same. This is how the list works. And our challenge is we need to put the entries over here from the new option. But the problem is we cannot give the access to all the people in the organization or most of them in the same list, because they can get inside, they can change the details, because as I said, it's a dynamic page and edits can be done. People can edit the list content. So to avoid this confusion, we need to have a solution where we can put the entries while we are not inside the list. That means if I'm outside the list and I'm making some entries, then only also my list is getting updated. And how I can do that? With the help of Microsoft Forms. So have you guys used Microsoft Forms before? Just to check. Okay. One person has raised their hand. Have used that? Okay. So I can see many of them has not used it before. So I'll just give you guys a brief introduction how the Microsoft form looks like. I think you guys might have used the Google form, because mostly we have seen that. Thanks for the confirmation. So I'll just open that office.com once again. As I said, to access the information related to Microsoft applications and products, we need to get to the landing page, which is office.com. Inside that, I'll be opening the nine dots again, and there would be forms. This icon would be looking like this. And if I open this, this is how my Microsoft Forms looks like. Here I can create a new form by clicking on this new form section. And I need to create a form which is exactly having the same tables inside list. So inside my SharePoint list, what are the tables that I have? I have title, I have phone number, I have email address and department. The same way I need to choose it over here. So I can put the name as employee details. And here, the first option would be the employee name, so the title. So I can choose that as text over here. I can put as title because I have title mentioned over here for the first column. I'm putting it as title. And I do not require it as a long answer. So it's fine, just the title. Next, I have phone number. So next I'll be choosing number is not there. So I'll be choosing text again, and I'll mention it as phone number. Because in the text value, it also consists the numbers and the special characters. So it's fine if you guys choose text and put the title as phone number. Next, I have email address. Again, as I said, the special characters, numbers, @, can be present inside text. So I'll be choosing text again, and I'll mention the heading as email address. Okay. And then I have department. But just to mention it once again, have you seen that when I'm making a new entry, and when I clicked on this department tab, I can see there are multiple options. That means there are multiple choices. So if I have scenarios like this, then I need to click on this forms and I need to select choices over here. I'll be having an option choices. So if I choose that, I'll be having multiple options which I can put as different choice. So I'll put the title as department first. Then what was the first option in my SharePoint? HR, sales, IT, marketing, accounts. The first option would be HR. Second, sales. Another option, what was that? HR, sales, IT, marketing, accounts. IT, marketing, accounts. So these are the different teams in my organization, in my office. So now I have successfully created the form within a minute. Now I would like to view how the form looks like. For that, we have one preview option on the top right section. If I click on the preview option, my form would be looking like this, where people will put their answer, and I want this answer to get captured inside SharePoint over here on this. To capture this, here I need the automation. The Power Automate comes into the picture. If we just talk about next topic, that is the Power Automate overview and the basic Power Automate flow. So these are the topics which we are going to discuss. What is the Power Automate? And before going ahead into this about Power Automate, have you guys used any Power applications or not? I have a few questions for you guys. I'll just drop these questions into the chat box. If you guys answer them, that would be great. So that I can have an idea if you guys have used any technologies from these things. So my first question is, you can write the answer with A, B, or C. That's fine. So just like, I would like to know, have you guys used SharePoint before or any technology inside SharePoint, or it's new to you guys? Okay. I have given a question in the chat box. So if you guys just type the option as A, B, or C, that would be fine. Okay. So it's nice to see that many of you guys have the experience with SharePoint, and many of us have seeing this for the first time. We are new to this. That's fine. It's very easy and interesting topic, which is SharePoint online and like the Power Automation and all this. And that's gonna definitely help the organizations in the future. So this automation, SharePoint online, cloud technology and everything is going to replace that our infrastructure inside the office or infrastructure inside a location base. Because nowadays we are working globally. We have offices in multiple locations and different sectors. So this is the technology of the future. I would not say future because we are already using this. So at the present and for the future, this is the technology are going to happen. Now, next, I have another question to put in the chat box. Instead of putting the question, let me just create a poll direct. I'm not sharing my screen at the moment. So I'm sharing a few options with you guys. Let me share one poll in the chat box in a minute. Okay. So you can choose your answers from this list of questions. So have you heard about any applications over there from the Power Apps, Power Automate, or just would like to know? So you can choose the poll over there. Okay, I can see most of the people have heard about this. I have 15 responses. That's nice. I would request you guys to take the poll because we have almost 60 people in the bridge. So at least if we have 40 to 45 responses, that would be great. Okay. We have seen that significance of number on all of them and Power BI. Most of the people are aware about the Power BI. And at the same time with the other applications. So that's why that's interesting because in the upcoming modules, we'll be going to discuss about the Power Automate, which most of the people are not aware about. So that would be a good thing. But at the same time, I would like to discuss in this session that this topic, which we are going to cover, it's not a basic or beginner level. It's an intermediate level. That means you need to have a knowledge in Power Automate to understand the automation. And it doesn't require any person to have a knowledge in coding or something like that because Power Automate is designed in a way where you do not require any coding or something like that. So I'll be sharing my screen once again. So firstly, how we can have all the Power applications or Power platforms with us. For first, again, as I said, the initial step is we need to go to the office.com. So first, we are opening the office.com. Then we have to click on the Power Automate. Here we'll find the option and the logo would be looking like this. It would take some time. And this is the landing page for Power Automate. And in the Power platform, we have multiple applications. So if you click on this Power Platform over here, you'll be able to see we have Power Apps, Power BI, Power Pages, Power Virtual Agents, and Power Platform Admin Center. And Power Automate is one of the application from Power Platform. Since I'm already inside the Power Automate, that's the reason I am not able to find this Power Automate over here. Now inside Power Automate, I can do multiple automations, not only with SharePoint, with other applications as well. Suppose I want to post a video on YouTube. So I'm a YouTuber and I'd like to post a video on YouTube, suppose. And I want that whenever I post a video, that moment, okay, I cannot seem to submit my choice to be able to Power BI. Okay, no problem. That's fine. It's okay if you are not able to submit your choice, but if you know about Power BI, that's one of the Power Platform application. And we would like to focus on the Power Automate at this time. So what I was saying, Power Automate help us to automate all the feature. Now, I was giving an example that if I'm a YouTuber and whenever I'm posting a video on YouTube, I would like to post the notification on Facebook, on X handle, and in other places so that people would get to know that I'm posting a new video on YouTube. So for that, we have different automations can be customized over here. So similarly, we can click on templates. These templates would give us the option to form this kind of automation over here. So if I just type over here in YouTube, and you'll be able to see, we have that option, share your YouTube video on Twitter. Or when a YouTube video is uploaded, send an email. We can form this kind of automation. This is the feature of Power Automate, where you do not need to perform any manual task from your end. Everything can be automated. Now, apart from this, we are interested to create a flow with SharePoint and Microsoft Form, because our objective is to capture the details from this Microsoft Form, which we have created, and we would like to put the same details over there inside our SharePoint list. This is the level of automation which we are trying to achieve at the moment. So first, we need to link these two separate applications together. That would be our first agenda. For that, we will go to Power Automate again. This is where we have seen different templates. Now we will type a form. Then we'll get an option or a template over here, and that has been used by, you can see, 7,24,428 people. So this many number of people have used this automation, and it's written as record form responses in SharePoint. We have to choose this, and we need to click on continue. It will display your email address instead of mine. If it is not displaying, there would be a signing option. You need to click on this sign in, and it would be signed your account at this moment to that Power Automate application, and you need to click on continue. And once you open the page would look like this. And at the moment, we know the Copilot, which is an AI, has been integrated with Power Automate. And this is the new look and feel of Power Automate. And if you do not want this Power Automate to look like this, you can go back to the old designer by switching off this. And the designer would be looking like this. These are known as different step in Power Automate. This is the step one, which is the trigger or the initial step, and followed by other steps. Now, this is very simple to design and form an automation. We do not, as I said, we do not need any coding language, not in any experience on that. Any fresher can also do that. Just we need to click on this, and we need to select the form which we have created. So what was the form name? Employee details. Let's get back to the Power Automate and select employee details. Next, inside this form ID, we need to select the same form once again. We have selected. Now, we know the source where we are getting the information. We have to confirm the destination at the same time. So for that, we have to click on this, where the item would be getting created inside SharePoint. So first, when you click on this, you'll have an option to put the link of SharePoint site. But if you can get the SharePoint site over here, you can choose that. But if you do not get that, you need to open the SharePoint first and copy the SharePoint list link. And then you can put it over here. But at the moment, I can see the football club, my name of my SharePoint site. After that, I can see the list name. What was my list name? It is contacts. Let me go and select the contacts over here. Similarly, I'm selecting contact because I need to mention, I need to provide the information to Power Automate that where I would like to create the new entries. Here, when I choose the contact, I can see the options popped up, which was there inside my SharePoint. Name, phone number, email address, and department. Can you see that? Name, phone number, email address, and department. So what I want, all these things, I want to be dynamic. Because every time, not the same people will submit the form. The people would be different. Suppose I want the name would be from the Microsoft form. So what was the form name which I have given over here? That is title. So I'll select this. If I select this and there is nothing, no new window will pop up, then I need to click on this add dynamic content. Then this window will pop up. Here we will have two options, dynamic content and expression. I'll be selecting dynamic content, and you will have this form icon over here. You need to select title in the form of name. Then for phone number, we need to select the dynamic content as phone number. For email address, again, the dynamic content would be email address. And for department value, the dynamic content, again, I need to select this custom value, dynamic content, and department. Because the same thing which I have given inside over there. So now my automation is completely built. Sure. So for the attendance, a link has been given in the chat box, which you guys can use to share the feedback and the attendance. So that's the later part. We'll have a dedicated 5 minutes on the end for that. Now we have created the entire automation. We are going to save it. After saving it, we need to test it, whether it's working properly or not. For that, we need to click on this flow checker, and we'll find there is no error or warnings. If there is, we need to make few changes according to that. But at the moment, if nothing is there, we are good to run the flow, then we need to click on test. We need to click on test manually for the first time. But later on, when the test flow is created, it would be repeated and we do not need to manually do it again and again. Just for the first time, we need to do it manually and we need to click on test. Now, what it says that to see it work now, submit a new response to the selected form. So let's go back to the form. This is the form which I have selected. Now, how I can provide this form to other people to submit the responses? What I can do, I can click on this back. I can click on this collect responses. Then I'll have a link over here. I can shorten the link. I'll copy the link and I'll open the link in a different browser. Okay. So it says you do not have permission to view the response of this form. Why? Because the form which I have created over here, I have not given the permission to anyone. It is given only the people in my organization, which is named as Contoso for the demo account, can submit the form. So if I just change it to this one, if I change this to anyone can respond, so that would not require any person to sign in. So I'll choose this one. Now I'll try to refresh the page. See, I can see the form now because there is no restriction as such at the moment. Next, we are putting the title over here as just for my name as Rahul. My phone number is 123 and my email ID is rahul.dandi@koenigsolutions.com. And I'm in the IT team. So I'm just choosing the response like this. I'm submitting that. The response has been submitted. Let's go back to the Power Automate to see if that is working properly or not. So we have came back to the Power Automate. Now it's showing me a notification that your flow ran successfully. How to confirm that now? I need to go back to the SharePoint. In my list, if I just scroll down, the last entry was from Peter, right? Now I need to refresh the page. Or if I do not refresh, I need to wait for 5 to 10 minutes, it would get updated. So if I just scroll down in the below, I can see my name, Rahul, is there with my phone number, email ID, and my department. That's how we can form the automation outside from SharePoint, but I can make the entry. So what are the use cases of this? I can use this in different sector. I can use this in the office. I can use this in a restaurant, any customer facing environment where customer can put their feedback or customer can put the requirement of their product or something like that. And we can get the entire thing within a SharePoint list. Now there's a question asked by Zaina in the chat box. How do we create without template? So it's a good question. Okay, I'll come down to that question later. Just for Zaina's question first. When I go to the Power Automate, if I click on Power Automate from this option. So in Power Automate, we have the template over here, but the create option on the top, just below the home section. If you click on this create, here you can build different flows. At the moment, we are using this automated cloud flow. That is what I have in my PPT. In Power Automate, we have different things, but since it's just only a 1 hour class, so it's very difficult to cover all the topics over here, how you can create and flow from scratch, how you can put different things, how you can build this kind of automation. That's a very, very difficult task to perform or complete within an hour. So for that, if you guys are interested for any detailed discussion on this, you can write down the topics on the chat box. For that, I can plan a future session on a separately on Power Automate or SharePoint, something like that. But for today, it was a crash course for Power Automate and SharePoint, how we can integrate both of them at the same time. So I'll just take questions in the chat box. Okay, how do we validate, for example, phone number? I can type my name on the phone number on the text box. Yeah, so for that, you can use filters on SharePoint itself where you're getting the answers. And if you are not getting any answer in the form of the form which you have given, if it is not the correct one, that would discard that. So again, as I said, it's a separate topic altogether. If you want me to cover that on the later half, on the later portion, I can definitely do that. And have a small question for you guys, since after covering this small session. So I'll just put the link on the chat box. Let me put the link. And I would request you guys, if you just take this question and answer. This is a small Q&A test. Okay. Just you guys need to put the answer which you feel like. And these questions are very simple. Believe me, guys. I'll just post the link on the chat box. Because in our company, in Koenig, we do provide certifications. Because there are multiple certifications offered by Microsoft. And starting from Microsoft 900, MS 102, these are the name of certifications. So if you guys have already completed any of them, you guys would be knowing that. But if you have any interest to cover any kind of certifications or anything in the future, you can contact our team or our website. This is the name where you can view. Is I'll just put the URL over here in the chat box. So this is the URL of our website. And if you have any query or anything about any question, you can reach out to me. This is my email ID. You can send me email. This is my official email ID. And about the Q&A, which I was saying, this is the link where you can open and put the answers over here. I would request you guys to click on this link of this QBuild 42. As I said, we do offer certifications. So this kind of Q&A sessions help you guys to enhance the, the look and feel, how you can increase your, the knowledge on the theory part, because in the certifications, we do get most of the questions from the theory section. And as I showed all the sections on the practical in my screen, that on the theory part, on the questions, you can expect the same on the link, which I have provided in the chat box. So you can just click on the link and you can put your email address and it will allow you to take the questions. So it's a very small test with 5 questions out there. Yeah, I can see many of you have started the Q&A. That's great. Looks great. Yeah, as I said, it's a very small thing. Just you need to put the answers over there. If it is correct or not correct, it will give you the correct answers. And there is no negative marking or something like that. So feel free to take the questions. Yeah. As I said, SharePoint is a large and vast topic. If you have any queries related to SharePoint or Power Automate, the automation, if you like the journey, and if you want any future course on the same topic, you can let me know or you can write in the chat box. We'll definitely plan it for the future. Okay. And that's all for the day. I would appreciate you all for joining in the session, your patience for being with me for the entire time. And if you have any questions, as I said, going ahead, you can let me know and you can send me emails. That's fine. And you can share the feedback on the given link. Thank you guys once again for all the cooperation and thanks for joining the session.
Thank you everyone for joining. Thank you Rahul for that lovely session as well. I have shared my email address. If anybody wants to continue for the enrollment of the course, kindly forward me the details so that our expert can get back to you with the required details. And kindly fill the attendance sheet as well for the webinar certificates. And do follow us on LinkedIn for further updates. Thank you, Rahul. Thank you, everyone, for joining. Bye-bye.